Today's topic is about reduction of scrap material for injection molding processes. Reduction of scrap material can be covered in two levels, via quality control of incoming master batches using DSC, and process optimization with integration of pressure and temperature sensors. My name is Danny Dewaert and I'm the sales and product manager for the thermal analysis and molding optimization business units at Technex. Technex is a distribution company and acts as partner for manufacturers such as Netz Analyzing and Testing from Germany and Priamus, which is part of the Barnes Group and located in Switzerland. Thermoplastics in the automotive. Thermoplastics have significantly gained importance in the automotive since the 1960s. Cars transformed from metal colossus to modern and much lighter versions. Why thermoplastics? Because of the low density, freedom of design, and easy integration of functionalities. On the other hand, it also brings challenges. Prices for parts need to be as low as possible, and highest quality is crucial. Therefore, producers need to verify the quality of the incoming process material and monitor the processes carefully. Only then a cost-effective production with minimum scrap production is possible. Quality control of the incoming material. This challenge can be overcome with the thermal analysis method called DSC. DSC stands for Differential Scanning Calorimetry and is an analytical method that gives characteristic thermal transitions of materials and substances. Some examples are glass transition temperature, melting temperature, and reaction temperature, such as curing. In general, DSC is based on a heat flow principle. A measurement of the energy difference between a sample and reference material during a temperature control program. The difference in energy between sample and reference material results in a peak area, which correlates to the heat of melting for the specific material and to the amount of energy that needs to be put into the material for melting. An application example. This graph shows the result of two different incoming production material batches. Interestingly enough, these are polymers which had the exact same melt flow indexes, and that is one of the more standard methods for incoming material control of polymers. However, from the result it can clearly be seen that these polymer blends are different in composition. The melting peaks of blend 1 are at higher temperature levels compared to blend 2, which is represented by the green line. After further analysis of the polymer blends, the conclusion was that polymer 1 had a lower PE low density content than the other polymer blend. What's the added value of a DSC? The instrument can operate as a sensitive quality control method in daily incoming production material control. Important quality parameters like melting point, crystallization, and glass transition temperature can easily be determined. Only if these parameters are known, the production process can be adjusted in such a way that scrap production can be minimized. Process optimization. Sensors in the injection mold provide data to the molder to set up the machine and parameters for optimal molded parts. The combination of both cavity pressure and cavity temperature sensors offer the greatest number of options to switch and to control the process and therefore allow for automation, process safety and cost savings independent from the machine or the operator. Closed loop control systems for the automatic balancing of multi-cavity molds can adjust and control the settings of the hot runner based on real-time process parameters measured inside the mold. Priamus has a wide range of cavity pressure and cavity temperature sensors. Most commonly used are the PriaSafe and the PriaSet cavity pressure sensors, which are mounted into the housing first before being calibrated. This procedure has the advantage that the sensitivity does not change after the sensor has been installed inside the mold, because it is protected. In a second step, the determined sensitivity will be saved inside the sensor with a hardware code. With the help of this hardware code, the sensor sensitivity can automatically be detected without being influenced by the sensor installation. The sensor is therefore easy to use, safe, and suitable for industrial production, resulting in high reproducibility on the process. Monitoring of the viscosity. By the use of two separate sensors, we are able to measure viscosity. The pressure sensor should be located near the gate to see the complete process, including filling and not only the compression phase. The temperature sensor needs to be located close to the end of the fill for melt front detection and can be used for switchover, venting issues, and gives indication if the part is properly filled. We actually measure the cavity pressure and temperature and calculate the shear rate and shear stress. This results in the viscosity. The added value of pressure and temperature sensors. Compression is determined by the cavity pressure during the holding pressure phase and then automatically adjusted. Dimension is determined and controlled by measuring the cavity temperature in relation to the cavity pressure. Adding both cavity pressure and cavity temperature sensors in the process results in a direct cost saver in terms of scrap material. Thank you for your attention and I hope to see you at the Meet the Match.